The robust economy is resulting in strong demand for Christmas trees. According to a report, fake tree sales increased 12% last year, while real tree sales grew by 20%. Standing by with a behind-the-scenes look at the Christmas tree business are Stefaney Rants, a popular lifestyle expert and TV host, and Scott Lucas, a third-generation Christmas tree grower. Hello to both of you. And why should people choose a real Christmas tree? There are some really good fakes out there.
Yeah, but Stephanie and I both agree that there's really nothing like a real Christmas tree to create those memories. It's part of a tradition. You go on the lot with your family, you search for that perfect tree, you find the one that's best for you. The smell, everything about it, the experience, it's just great.
Absolutely. And I grew up in the Pacific Northwest, and we would select a real tree year after year and had so much fun going to our local farm. So much so that now that I have a family of my own, I don't live in the Pacific Northwest anymore. I actually live in Florida. But yes, real trees can be found, you know, throughout North America, which is so great. And I'm able to continue that tradition with my family. My daughter is almost 5 and she loves it. She has so much fun. So it's definitely a unique experience and something unlike anything else we'll do for the entire year.
What about the environment? Is it bad to cut down trees, or is it a rotation system?
Well, trees are actually real Christmas trees. Harvesting them is not bad for the environment. They're biodegradable. They're grown specifically for this purpose, just like any other crop, like or pumpkins for Halloween or roses for Valentine's Day. They're grown for this specific purpose. And then when you're done with them, they get recycled. Unlike an artificial tree, which, you know, the plastics and metals that are used to build them, you know, after a few years, if the tree breaks, you got to throw it away and put it in a landfill. So it's actually the far more eco-friendly option to go with a real tree.
Yeah, and Scott was telling me that for every real tree that is harvested, at least one new one will be planted in its place, so you can feel really good about it.
We would love to get some tips on how to care for the tree and removal.
Taking care of the tree basically comes down to keeping it watered. You want to make sure that the water is always filling the tree so it stays hydrated. It's going to be very thirsty when you take it home, so make sure you give it some water. Make sure you give it a fresh cut, maybe an inch or a half an inch, just to encourage that absorption of the water, and then leave it away from any windows that might beat the heat from the sun on it all day long, or any vents that might dry out the tree faster.
And then to dispose of it, you have a couple options. You can always put it in your garden or your compost and chop it up, put it in your own yard, or you can just double check with your community. A lot of them have disposal services specifically for Christmas trees, so just double check.
Thank you to you both, and Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
Thanks for having us.
And for more information, you can head to itschristmaskeepitreal.com for more information on real trees and to enter the photo contest, Real Trees, Real Memories.
For more Business First AM, check us out on social media. We're on Facebook, YouTube, and Twitter. And go to businessfirstam.com for where to see our show on TV.